I just got the results from my annual blood test. My cholesterol is off the charts, and my doctor wants me to start taking medications right away. I don't understand. I lift weights, I eat well, I'm pretty young, I don't smoke. What happened? Does this scenario sound familiar? Disclaimer, this has not happened to me just yet. Whether you've been diagnosed with high cholesterol or not, it's important to understand that anyone can lower their cholesterol levels, and that's always a good thing. It really boils down to knowledge and habit changing. Once you have the knowledge to do what's right for you, you are more likely to replace those habits that are harming your health for habits that don't. I know it's not easy, and we don't have to have a perfect diet every day, but we also have to be realistic and not expect different results if we don't make any changes. Isn't that pretty much the definition of insanity? So today I'm going to explain what cholesterol is, why do we need it, and yes, we need it, and proven techniques to lowering it without pills. Hi guys, I'm Begonia. I'm a nutrition and health professor that loves to share tips and simple ideas to help you become healthier. I hope you join me by subscribing to my channel, Simply Health. Cholesterol is a type of fat that provides us with no calories. The body makes all the cholesterol that it needs, so we don't need to get any from our diets. Because cholesterol is a fatty substance and our bodies are very watery, it needs a special form of transportation. Otherwise, it would float on top of our watery fluids, kind of like oil floats on top of water. The transport of cholesterol and all other fats needs a special type of protein called a lipoprotein. Think of lipoproteins as buses that take cholesterol to different places in the body. The main two types of lipoproteins that most people have heard of are LDL and HDL. LDL, or low density lipoprotein, is also known as the bad cholesterol because it transports cholesterol from the liver to the cells throughout the body. So LDL keeps cholesterol inside the body, and that cholesterol ends up accumulating, leading to a condition known as atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis is a buildup of cholesterol in the wall of our arteries, which causes our arteries to shrink and blood flow to be restricted and eventually stop. That is when a heart attack or a stroke can occur. This can be avoided even if you've been diagnosed with high cholesterol by following the tips that I will share with you. HDL is known as the good cholesterol because it transports cholesterol from body cells to the liver, and then the liver gets rid of that cholesterol. So HDL helps remove cholesterol from the body and blood cholesterol levels decrease. This is associated with a decreased risk of atherosclerosis, heart attacks, and strokes. So to protect our hearts and our brains, our goal is to lower our LDL, or bad cholesterol, and to increase our HDL, or good cholesterol. So why do we need cholesterol? Most people have heard only bad things about cholesterol, but it has crucial functions in the body. Our bodies make cholesterol naturally soon after conception, during fetal development. This important molecule is the raw material for sex hormones like testosterone, progesterone, and estrogen. Once we are born, all of our trillions of cells in the body contain cholesterol. Our bodies then need cholesterol to, one, continue to make sex hormones, two, make vitamin D, and three, make bile to help with fat digestion. Cholesterol is only made by animals, not plants. It's the same molecule regardless of the animal that makes it. It was first believed that foods high in cholesterol were bad for you because they increase the cholesterol in your body. But now we understand that this isn't true for most people. For people with diabetes, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, or heart disease, foods that are high in cholesterol do increase cholesterol levels. For everyone else, the biggest problem is saturated fats and trans fats in our diets. Those increase cholesterol levels. Here are proven tips to control and lower cholesterol. One, lower your saturated fat intake. It is well established that diets high in saturated fats increase your bad cholesterol which in turn increases your risk of atherosclerosis and heart disease. Heart disease is the leading cause of death in the United States and around the world. About 1 in 3 deaths are due to heart disease. The top sources of saturated fats in our diets come from cheese, beef, milk, sausages, hot dogs, bacon, deli meats, and tropical oils. What you can do instead is eat leaner meats such as roasted chicken, removing the skin, and turkey. You can try meatless Mondays, where instead of meat, you incorporate beans, tree nuts, and vegan options. You can also substitute meat for fatty fish like salmon, sardines, anchovies, or rainbow trout. For sandwiches, try tuna sandwiches, egg salad sandwiches, I will talk about eggs in a minute, peanut butter sandwiches, hummus with vegetables like cucumber, tomatoes, and lettuce. Make sure you include whole wheat bread with those sandwiches. 2, lower your intake of fried foods. Some examples can be chicken wings, mozzarella sticks, onion rings, and French fries. If you enjoy that crunchy fried food feel, use an air fryer and toss your food in a little olive oil instead. Minimize intake of baked goods. These are really high in saturated fats and trans fats. 4, lower your daily trans fat intake. That means start checking ingredients lists and look for hydrogenated oils. Trans fats are the worst fats for us, as they increase our bad cholesterol and decrease our good cholesterol. That couldn't be worse for our hearts. Replace bad fats with healthy fats. It's not just about lowering saturated and trans fats, it's also about replacing them with the right foods. So replace them with healthy fats, like fats from avocado, olives, and fatty fish. Also tree nuts like walnuts and almonds. Increase your fiber intake, especially from whole grains, fruits and vegetables, and beans. It is very well proven that fiber decreases your total cholesterol levels. Eggs. This is probably one of the most confusing and controversial foods out there. I remember when I was in grad school, we were told, do not eat eggs. They have too much cholesterol. They're really bad for you. Now the message is, eggs are okay for most people. Most people? What the heck does that mean? Well, if you're a diabetic or have high cholesterol, high blood pressure, or heart disease, eggs will impact you negatively, so steer away from them. If you don't have any of those diseases and they're not in your family, I recommend not to eat more than 3 to 4 eggs a week. Quit smoking. Here's another reason to quit. Smoking increases the deposit of bad cholesterol in your arteries, leading to more blood restriction and atherosclerosis. It also increases your blood pressure, which is always a leading reason for heart disease. 9, exercise right and exercise enough. Although all exercise is awesome, there is certain exercise that it's better for lowering blood cholesterol. That is aerobic exercise. Lasting at least 30 minutes a day has been proven to lower your LDL levels. Some examples include brisk walking, hiking, running, cycling, rowing. If you play sports, soccer, or basketball, start slow, but try to get at least 30 minutes a day. Lastly, manage your stress. Everybody has stress. It's just a matter of you managing the stress instead of stress managing you. Uncontrolled stress causes LDL levels to go up. This is the bad cholesterol, which in turn can lead to atherosclerosis and heart disease. Daily stretching, yoga, and meditation have been proven excellent tools to control stress. I know, it seems like all the yummy stuff is off limits, but it really isn't. Please don't shoot the messenger. I'm a true believer of having days off when you treat yourself to something that is not so healthy. For example, I don't remember the last time I had a donut, but my birthday is coming up and I think I'm going to treat myself to one. The key is to understand that treats should be left for special occasions like birthdays or holidays. That is why we call it a treat. Thank you so much for sharing this time with me. I hope this information was helpful. Remember to press the like button and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, cheers to your health.